Charles Carter. Krista Nyman. Wes Nyman. Charlotte Harris. Betty Reinhardt. David Reinhardt. Keith Word. Here before you are your new local church lay servants. Congratulations. Not rude. But first, Randall has something that he'd like to share with you.
These are not only your servants now, but God's servants as they enter a new and different phase of their life to become official lay servants. I want to tell a story that I heard recently. A man named Michael Heberger from East Rochester, New York, was on his way home from work and realized he needed to stop and pick up a few things before he got home. He stopped at a small grocery store that he was not familiar with, went inside, picked out his items, and as he got in the checkout line, there were two people ahead of him. In front of him, in the middle between himself and the lady who was checking out, was a rather nicely dressed middle-aged man. At the front of the line was an elderly lady who appeared to him to be living on the edges of life. She was in the process of trying to check out and pay for her groceries. She had a can of tuna, a small loaf of bread, a pint of milk, and a small pack of cookies. And as she counted change out from her handkerchief, the clerk told her, says, "Ma'am, you're 86 cents short." And she continued to fumble in her purse without any success. And so the man in front of Michael, he saw him reach into his pocket and he picked out a dollar bill and folded it, put it in his hand, and he reached down toward the floor like he was picking it up. Touched the elderly lady on the arm and said, "Ma'am, you may have dropped this." These people, along with many in the Methodist Church and throughout the Christian world, become that man in the middle has to find the opportunity to help those who are 86 cents short. They're 86 cents short in life. They're 86